Hello, my name is Aubrey Tyler Keel. I am 24 years old. I'm the head maintenance supervisor for Faith City Mission, and I am also in the 12-month-long Hope for Men program. I have one sister that is 8 years older than me, that have one brother that is 4 years older than me. Growing up, I was never close to them, so at times I felt like an only child. At 8 years old, me and my best friend at the time stole a pack of his mom's cigarettes, and he dared me to actually leave him. Since then, I've been addicted to nicotine. Since I was never close to my siblings, one of my issues was that I always seeked out older friends. Like when I was 13, a couple of seniors from Amarillo High School took me to my first party, where I drank my first beer and smoked my first bowl of weed. I was always in trouble at school. I was very rebellious. I didn't like people telling me what I had to do, what I cannot do. Also, if you were to challenge me to do something, such as my homework, I would have looked at you in the face and said that I don't have to prove myself. That was the angle my mom used to try on me. So my parents took me out of public school so that they could keep an eye on me. So my first and only year of homeschool, 8th grade, I actually did my schoolwork. Also, my dad is an evangelist and has been spreading the gospel of Jesus Christ my whole life. So my 8th grade year of homeschool, I got to do some traveling and a lot of Bible work. The following summer, however, I had gotten in contact with some of my old friends. Parties, drinking, and smoking weed became a very regular thing for me at a very early age. When I was 16, I snuck out of my parents' house for the first time and walked to some guy's house I had met, and that was where I tried cocaine for the first time. My work life was fine till I was 18. I was involved with Bob Mills Furniture, Whataburger, a cattle feed store. When I turned 18, my best friend at the time was throwing a graduation party, and that was where I had ecstasy for the first time. Ecstasy was my drug of choice after that. I was no longer able to hold a job, so selling drugs became my way of getting around. After I turned 20, I got a job at Quality Carpet and Flooring, where I learned a good work ethic. And I might have calmed down on my drug use. Also, I took on the responsibility of rent and a cell phone bill. I met a beautiful girl who became pregnant with my son. And a few months later, we became married. After 2 years of constantly going out of town for my construction job, moving from apartment to apartment, paying for two cars, an old friend appeared back into my life. He needed a place to stay for 2 weeks, so me and my wife welcomed him into my home. He was a very good guest, cleaned up after himself, and helped out a lot. However, it was a weekend that I was home for a couple of weeks due to some low business. I went outside one morning to smoke a blow of my weed, and my friend said he would join me. So I passed him the pipe, and he said, "I don't smoke weed anymore. I smoke meth." So I told him I didn't care as long as it didn't make him trip out or crazy. Needless to say, I became curious, and that was when my addiction to meth started. It was something new to me because the feeling and the rush was extreme, but I could still control myself. So I thought it became a habit and something that I did constantly. My job became unimportant, and I lost it because I fell out when I was supposed to leave for work one morning. Then me and my wife became distant, ending in a divorce. The same month that I was filed for divorce, two of my real, godly best friends had died in a car wreck. Dealing drugs became central to my life once again, but this time it was serious. Meth had taken over my life and has destroyed it. Eventually, things got worse when I began to inject meth into my arms. In the beginning of that period, I went from shooting up 1 to 2 times a day. 8 months later, I was doing twice as much in volume, sometimes up to 10 times daily. My life had become dark, scary, and alone. My dad took me to lunch one day, worried about my poor eating habit. Told me about face intermission. Right off the bat when I got there, they blessed me with the responsibilities of being the maintenance guy there. And they have provided the protection from the outside world. And for a chance to get sober and to get my thoughts and my mind back in order. I've been there for over 6 months. I have also been able to take care of my 3 hair follicle drug tests in order to see my son. Me and my parents have a relationship now that is better than ever. Also, my dad is not only my spiritual mentor and advisor, but he is to several other students in the program.